that the illustrator of the Rider Waite Tarot was a woman, and beyond that, she was a woman of color? Neither did I. Welcome back to Tarot Tuesday, and today we're going to have a little bit of a history lesson as we talk about Pamela Colman Smith, who was the illustrator who drew all of the artwork for the Rider Waite Tarot deck. I have the miniature edition of the Rider Waite Tarot here, but you can see on the back of the box that US Game Systems has put a huge shout out to Pamela Colman Smith, the illustrator of the Rider Waite deck. They've done this intentionally because her name is not found in the name of the deck. Arthur Waite was the original author of the deck. Pamela was hired to do the artwork. And at the time, it wasn't seen as important to give her the credit that she deserved. So to make amends, US Game Systems has really put a shout out to her on the box, which I think is great. But let's talk about Pamela and her life. Pamela Colman Smith, AKA Pixie, to those who knew her well, was an only child of her parents, born in February 16, 1878 in London, and grew up in the UK until she was about 10 years old when she moved to Jamaica. When she lived in Jamaica, she learned a lot about the native folklore and traditions and stories that were told there, and it really became a part of her identity. In 1893, when she was 15 years old, she moved to Brooklyn and attended Pratt Institute, which was a private university, where she was studying fine arts and illustration. She completed 2 years there, but she left before she received her degree. There's different speculation as to why she left, but it's possibly due to the fact that her mother passed away from a severe illness, and Pixie herself was quite ill during the time that she was there. Regardless though, she still managed to find employment as an illustrator. When she was 21, she moved to London. This is shortly after the death of her father. So at 21 years old, she was essentially an orphan. Her parents had passed away, she had no siblings. When she moved to London, she worked in the theater, and she was there with really famous names of the day. Bram Stoker, maybe one that you recognize. And it was during this time that she did a lot of work illustrating not only her own books, she did write quite a few of her own books, but she also did illustrations for other authors, including William Butler Yeats. She also illustrated for Bram Stoker, not his famous Dracula, but one of his other titles she did illustrate for him. She was active in the British suffragette movement and did illustrations and posters for that movement. She also created posters for the Red Cross during World War I. So she was quite active. Her artwork was getting a lot of attention. In the early 1900s, it's unclear what the date is exactly, but in the early 1900s, she joined the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn, which is the organization that Arthur Waite was a member of. So it is speculated that it is through this organization that the two met, which is also how she got the commission to create the artwork for Arthur Waite's deck. It is unclear whether Arthur Waite gave her the direction for each card, what the art should look like, or whether she created all of the meaning and symbolism within the art based on her own intuition and her own knowledge of the tarot. There is evidence that she researched other tarot decks and pulled some of her stylings from those decks. But what really set her apart is not only her art style, but the fact that she illustrated the entire deck. Up until this point, all the major arcana, as well as the court cards, were illustrated, but the pips, the 1 through 10, didn't really get any illustrations. And so Pixie illustrated every single one of them to really give them a concrete definition and meaning. Despite the huge commercial success of the Rider Waite deck, she actually didn't get paid very much for it. She writes to the publisher asking for payment for the artwork that she didn't ask for much, but she also didn't receive much either. Unfortunately, she never saw a lot of commercial success for her artwork, and she never reaped the benefits of the sales from the Rider Waite tarot deck. And she passed away in 1951 penniless, with no children, and she was never married. Now, she may very well have fallen into obscurity in history, but Stuart Kaplan, who is the founder of the US Game Systems, who currently publishes the Rider Waite deck, took a keen interest in Pamela Colman Smith and did a whole lot of research on her because he felt that it was as important that she be recognized for her contribution to the tarot as any of the other people who were involved in its creation. Today, if you go to the US Game Systems website, there's an entire page dedicated to Pamela Colman Smith. Additionally, if you purchase one of the Rider Tarot decks from US Game Systems, it will come with a card within the deck that has a bio for Pamela Colman Smith. This is how important it is that her memory and her legacy live on. So when you look at the artwork, recall that this is a talented woman who's creating these illustrations, using her own intuition, using guidance, and not getting a whole lot of recognition for it. So give her a little shout out when you do your readings. And hopefully that's been a little bit enlightening to you as to how these cards were created and just who Pixie was. I hope you've enjoyed this Tarot Tuesday, and we will see you next week.